Obsidian is great right out of the box. Today, we will take the way we use templates to the next level, and the next, and the next. Yes, three levels of how to make your Obsidian templates smarter and more efficient. Let's go. Before we do anything else, let's do some housekeeping and create a folder for all our templates. I will go all creative and call it templates. You will see in a moment why we need this. Now it is time to install the one plugin we need on this level, Templater. Templater lets you insert variables and functions into your nodes. It also allows you to execute JavaScript code and system commands. If all this sounds confusing, don't worry. I'm far from being a programmer or understanding JavaScript myself, but Templater is easy to get into and very well documented. First, we need to enable community plugins in the Obsidian settings. Click on the settings icon in the bottom left-hand corner. Go to Community Plugins and click on Turn on Community Plugins. Then click on Browse, search for the Templater plugin, install and enable it. Then we can close the settings for now. Back in Obsidian, we start with an empty node. I will call this one the L1 Meeting Template. The first step in making the template smart is that we want it to ask for a title whenever we create a new node. This is done by adding a bit of code to the template's front meta. This is the part of a node that contains metadata, and in our case, some logic. By the way, I also created written instructions on my blog from where you can copy the code snippet. As always, I left the link in the description below. The first part of this block contains the logic that checks whether a node title equals untitled, which is the default when we create a new one. And if so, prompts you to enter a new one. Additionally, it contains a property for when the node was created and modified. The former is updated automatically, but the latter needs to be updated manually whenever you modify the node in the future. Then we have the alias property. Here you can define one or more aliases for the node. This can help with finding the node via the Obsidian search in the future. The last property I added here is tags. With tags, you can easily categorize your nodes, which is really helpful for keeping them organized. As you can see, I added a tag here called meetings. This will let me find all my meeting nodes easily, regardless of where they are stored, because whenever I create a node based on this template, this tag will already be in there. Of course, you can remove or add properties as you see fit, following the same pattern. With the front meta done, I want to build the node's structure. The first heading is the meeting title. This may seem redundant, but it is very helpful if you want to share your nodes via PDF or print them. After that, I start with logistics, including the meeting date, time, and location. Then I want to keep track of the participants. As I am taking the notes, it seems safe to add myself here by default. Every meeting should have an agenda or objectives, so I put those next. The whole point of this is to take notes about the discussed items, so adding a notes section makes a lot of sense. And if we intend to get anything done as a result of our meeting, we need to define action items. I separate them into those for myself and those assigned to others, but that's a personal preference. Again, this is a suggested structure. You can adapt this or build your own from scratch. Now, this looks pretty good, but we can add a few finishing touches. I will use Templater to add the node's creation date as the meeting date. Of course, you can always change it, but I find that in most cases, I create the node on the same day as the actual meeting happens. Then, I want to define a few cursor positions, to which I can quickly jump for entering text. Once again, Templater can do that for us. We just add the code TP file cursor with a number to each of our positions. In this case, I have 5 of these positions defined. To make this work, we need to enable the jump to cursor feature in the Templater settings. Let's go back there and quickly turn it on. Once the node is created, we can jump to these positions with a hotkey. By default, this is defined as Alt and Tab, which is not great because that's used for switching between applications in Windows. So let's quickly change this by going to Settings, Hotkeys, and searching for Jump to Next Cursor Location. And here I define Control and Tab as a new hotkey. This causes a conflict inside of Obsidian, but I can resolve that one right away as well. We just go to the command that has the same hotkey assigned and remove it from there. Talking about hotkeys, we can also define a hotkey to create new nodes based on a specific template. So instead of creating a new node and then applying the template, we can do this in one quick move. To do so, we need to go to the Templater settings and select the template for which we want to add a hotkey. in our case, the L1 meeting template. Then click on the little plus icon next to the template selector. Once in the hotkey settings dialog, search for meeting. You should find the command for inserting the level 1 meeting template. Click on the plus icon and then just press the hotkey of your choice. I will use Alt and M, like meeting. If you close the settings and press the defined hotkey, Obsidian will ask me for the new node's name and then apply the template behind it. Fast and easy. One last tip on this level. Depending on how you organize your nodes, you may want to use the same template for all new nodes in a specific folder. For example, I will create a folder Meetings and I want Obsidian to always use the L1 meeting template for new nodes created in this folder. For that, we go back to the templater settings. Here, we first activate the option to trigger templater on new file creation. This adds a new section to these settings called Folder Templates. Scroll down there and select the Meetings folder and the L1 meeting template from the respective drop-down menus. Close the settings, right-click on the Meetings folder and select New Node. Obsidian will automatically use the L1 meetings template for that node. And this is how a single plugin can help you with making nodes creation much faster, easier, and more consistent. Now let's take a look at the next level. On level 2, we improve the way we track tasks and action items. To do so, we need two more plugins. First, the Tasks plugin, which tracks tasks across your entire vault. You can query them, for example with Data View, and mark them as done wherever you want. It also supports due dates, recurring tasks, done dates, subset of checklist items, and filtering. Second, the Checklist plugin. This shows a checklist in the right sidebar of Obsidian. By default, any checklist items you tag with hashtag todo will appear in this sidebar, but you can customize this and use your own tags, as we will see. To install them, we go back to the Obsidian settings, community plugins, and search for them. You already know how this works, so I will speed through this. Okay, now I will go to the checklist settings and define two more tags here. I like to use hashtag talk for things that I need to discuss with people. For example, I would put hashtag talk/management for any items that I need to bring up in the management call. The third tag I like to use is hashtag FUP. I use this for things that I need to follow up on rather than having to work on myself. So this is very useful for action items that get assigned to other people. Now we just need to make sure that the checklist window gets displayed in our sidebar. Here we go. Let's create a few tasks. Here is meeting node 1. I add some tasks and this is where the tasks plugin comes in really handy. It allows you to easily select things like start and due dates or priority. It will also add a close date automatically when you mark a task as done. If you don't like that, you can also disable it in the settings. Okay, let me also do this for meeting node 2, and we're done. As you can see, all the tasks that are tagged with one of the three defined tags show up in my checklist on the right hand side. I can click on them and jump to the node, or just mark them as completed, which updates the node too. And if you have tasks that you don't need to see in the checklist, well, then just don't tag them. And now we're off to the third level. On this level, we don't add functionality, but we introduce a way to make our nodes more visually appealing. To do so, we need yet another plugin. It's called the Multi-Column Markdown plugin. For now, you know what we have to do. Find the plugin, install, and enable it. Alright, now let's make a copy of our L1 template and call it L3 meeting template. Typically, the information about logistics and participants does not require the whole width of a page. So, I would like these two blocks to be side by side. To do so, I press Ctrl and P to open the command prompt and enter multi-column. I confirm that I want to insert a multi-column region at my current cursor's position. This adds some code to our template, which defines the start and end of the region and the end of columns inside the region. By default, we get two columns. This is fine for my purpose, so I don't change it. I would like these columns to have no border, so I disable them, and I also want them to have a shadow instead, and add this to the code. Now I just need to move the logistics block between the start of the region and the end of the first column, and the participants block goes between the end of the first column and the end of the region. If we now switch from the edit view to the reading view by pressing Ctrl and E, we can see that both blocks are nicely aligned and we don't waste as much space as before. It is worth mentioning that we can still format the text in each column just as we are used to, headings, lists, etc. are all possible. Note that sometimes the changes you apply to this multi-column region are not immediately visible. You might have to close the node and reopen it. Now let's see if this template also works as it should. I create a new node, select the template, I have not defined a hotkey for that one, and fill in some information. During edit mode, it doesn't look much different. But when I switch to the reading mode, it looks much better. For now, all these templates and a growing number of others can be downloaded for free via the link in the description. As you can see, Templater really has a lot of potential for automating your note-taking. Tasks and checklists make it so much easier to keep track of our and other people's action items. And the multi-column plugin helps us with saving space and arranging content blocks much more flexibly. I hope this helps you with making your notes faster, better structured, and more consistent. If you have any specific questions about Obsidian or any other productivity-related topic, let me know in the comments. If you found this video even remotely helpful, perhaps drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring the notification bell to make sure you won't miss the next videos. All this should allow you to save quite some time and be more productive. However, there are always more things we can do to increase our productivity, which you should really check out in this growing list of productivity tools and methods. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.